C C B B B A B A E A B A E G A B A F. The chords are C major, C E G. Keep the C major chord as you play the melody. Still C major. Here we're going to change to C sharp diminished. So C sharp, E, and G. To D minor, D, F, and A. To G seventh. So G, B, D, and F. And you can play that as an open chord or just the root. And this goes for any of the chords. So play to your level of comfort. You can simply play the root of each chord. So C, C sharp, D, G, or you can play them as blocked chords, or you can play them as written. Let's put this together. The melody is D, E, F, G, A, G, D, E, F, G, A, G sharp, A, G sharp, A, D sharp, D sharp. The chords are D minor, so D, F, and A, G major, G, B, D, back to the D minor, and to the G major. So all you're doing is just shifting between D minor to G, back and forth. Let's put this together. Now you'll notice sometimes that I'm adding the F to make it a G seventh. Again, have the freedom to really make these chords your own. And we're also taking the first section. So if you want to rewind and watch this part again, you would take the first ending. But now we're going to jump to the second ending because it's basically the same thing. The melody is A A G B C C C D C A C D C C C B A G E. Now the chords are, and remember we've jumped to the second ending because if you take the first ending, it's just repeating exactly what we've already played. So you're going to play the D major chord, which is D F sharp A, to the G major chord, G, B, D, and sometimes I add the B to make it a seventh. Again, make it your own, to C major, so C, E, and G. F major chord, F, A, C. Now F sharp diminished is F sharp, A, and C, to the C major chord. So all I've done here is I've moved from F sharp, A and C up to the C major chord in its inversion. So G, C, and E. Or an option could be you could play what's written E, D, C, B, or you could also double the melody in the right hand. So C, B, A, G, E. Totally up to you, or you can just even play the C major triad while your right hand plays the melody. Let's put this together and see what we come up with. The melody is C, C, D, C, A, C, D, C, G, G, A, B, A, G. Now the chords are A minor, A, C, E, to the D seventh chord. So D, F sharp, A, and C. Back to the A minor chord, A, C, and E. to the D7th chord, D, F sharp, and C. So in this section, you're just moving from A minor to D7th, A minor to D7th, and then finally to the G chord. So C, G, B, N, D. And then what I like to do here is I like to actually play the notes as written. Okay, but again, this is up to you. You can play just the blocked chords, or you can play as written, or you can just simply play the root of each chord. So A, D, A, D, and then to G. So it depends on your level of comfort, and I really want you to have the confidence to make this your own. So let's put this together and see what we come up with. The melody is C, 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 B, 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 A, B, A, E, A, B, A, E, G, A. Now, if you've noticed that little chromatic passage, all I'm done is I'm just simply playing what is written. So you're going to play A in with your fifth finger, and your second finger will play C sharp, D, E flat, and E. Although my keyboard says D sharp and E flat are the same note, it's just written inharmonically. So if you feel comfortable, you can play the notes as written, or you can just play the A in your right hand. The chords are C major, C, E, G, still C major, then you're gonna play still the C major chord. Now here you're going to play the E minor chord with a B flat in the bass. Now it sounds a little bit more scary than it is, so I'm going to give you a really simple option. Just play the B flat, okay? Just keep it simple. And then you're going to play the A major chord. So A, C sharp, and E. Now, if you want to follow what the score says, it would be A, B natural, C, and C sharp. Or you can just play the root chord while your right hand plays. But I kind of like to play this part as written, because that chromatic motion in thirds adds a little bit of fun and a little bit of spark to this section. So let's put it together and see what it sounds like. The melody is A, C, D, D, C, C, A flat, although my score reads G sharp. G sharp and A flat are the same note. So A flat, C, D, and the chords are F major, F, A, C, and then you're going to move to the F minor chord. So all you have to do is move your third finger from an A to an A flat, or from an A to a G sharp. Simple. Let's put it together. So here's the part where you get to be really creative. But first, let's go over the melody in the right hand. C, A natural, B, A, G, repeats, C, A, B, A, G, repeats again, C, A, B, C, D, C. Now, you can go up the octave up here, so instead of playing close to middle C, E, N, C, which is the sixth, you're going to move up to the next octave, or you can even play it super high if you like. Totally up to you. This is where you get to add your interpretive genius. So let's go over the chords for this section. It's D major, D, F sharp, A, to G major, G, B, and D. And it just repeats itself. So get really comfortable moving from D major to D major. Now, if you're not quite at that point, just rotate between D and G. Just play the roots of the chord like this. Okay, whatever works for you. And then you're going to play D major. And And then you're going to land on the C major chord. Now I want to give you a few different options for ending. So you can simply just stay and land on the C major chord, so C, E, G, okay? And you can just end it there, or you can play as written, okay? Or you can also play the C, the root, and then just kind of add the E flat or add a few notes, so E flat, E natural, and then play the low C, because your right hand, remember, is going to move up to an octave. It's up your choice. So I want you to have a lot of fun and feel a lot of freedom and make this ending your own. So let's put it together and see what we come up with.